Firstly, let's get one thing straight. This video is a critique of mainstream feminism, aka Brahmin Dvija feminism, but not a dismissal of feminism altogether. The recent discussions around Me Too and Sabarimala and several other injustices that have been happening since ages are the reasons why I'm here to talk about Brahmin Dvija feminism. For those of you who don't know, let's first discuss what Brahmin Dvija feminism is. It's really similar to what is defined as white feminism in the West. Something that completely ignores the rights of women, trans people and queer people from the marginalized sections of the society. It is sadly, of course for the obvious reasons, what we call mainstream feminism. Personally, it is not feminism to me where our womanhood is not enough womanhood for you. Not feminism for me when you keep occupying our space. We experience a three-layered oppression. By men, both forward caste and backward caste, and by women who are from forward caste. Okay, now let's discuss why Brahmin Dvija feminism is exclusionary. These feminists have always been ignorant to the rights and demands of the women from backward castes. For them, it's like the caste question doesn't exist or they conveniently avoid it. Let's address some of the issues that women fight for on a daily basis and I'll show you how these demands exclude us. Wages. Brahmin Dvija feminists fight for glass ceiling and equal wages, etc. The domestic workers in their houses, maids they call them, do they have a leave schedule? Will they increase their pay without being passive aggressive and without saying paise to barabar puchti hai kaam to karti nahi? What about their basic rights as human beings and as workers? What about the emotional abuse and the sexual abuse they go through by the men in your households? Speaking of sexual assault, how does sexual assault or harassment get dealt with in this country? There is a nationwide outrage about the rape cases that happen to Brahmin Dvija women. Where is the same outrage when it happens to a woman from marginalized section? Because your feminism is all about selective outrage. I have seen tremendous support that these women get, be it legal, medical or emotional. Whereas due process has been failing our women for decades now and nobody has ever come forward for even the basic legal help. Let's circle back to Me Too movement for a second.
A Dalit queer person named Raya Sarkar made a list of sexual harassers in academia.
Many Brahmin Dvija women said that it's a witch hunt and due process shall be followed. These same women, when the second wave of Me Too movement came to India, hailed it as the arrival of India's Me Too movement. See, anytime if there is any discussion around women's rights happens in India, there are specific set of women who will speak out. Who are these women that take hold of these discussions? What are their caste locations? It is different for the people from oppressed communities. We do not have the same amount of security and social capital to reveal our identities. And even if we do, we do not relate to these conversations because they are led by Brahmin Dvija women who are again our oppressors since ages. Let's talk about sex work. Brahmin Dvija feminists call sex work a choice by completely erasing the history of it and how women from marginalized sections are forced to do it. Let's move on to the interesting topic, representation in media. How were Bahujan women and transgender people portrayed in media? Google Brahmin women. See the image results. Now Google Dalit women or Adivasi women. See the image results. Now do you understand what I mean? The videos of our women getting stripped off, being paraded naked and beaten up goes viral. Have you ever come across any videos of Brahmin Dvija women getting beaten up or being paraded naked? No. Now about leadership roles. Brahmin Dvija feminists fight for the leadership roles in sectors like media, justice, law, academia, etc. and celebrate the progress of their women in that sector. Whereas these same women will not hire people from marginalized sections at all. Remember that you are not immune to caste bias and Brahminical patriarchy. Basically, when women talk about women's rights or women in general, the women for them are women from forward caste. Bell Hooks says the same about white feminists and their selective racist white feminism. Frankly, my dear, that doesn't count as feminism for me. So now about the buzzword intersectionality. Intersectionality means a feminism that respects all differences and works towards a more inclusive world for all the oppressed identities. Which is now shifted to a feminist practice where Brahmin Dvija feminists will grab the mic from us and talk about us and get global recognition for their work on us. Slow claps for them. One thing I want to tell you, intersectionality is not a sub-theme of feminism. It is what feminism is and should be. So my friend, if you're wondering how to be a more inclusive feminist and want to be better, here are some tips for you. Acknowledge your privilege and stop occupying all the space. Redistribute the sources you have to the marginalized without acting like a savior. Use your social capital for amplifying the voices of the marginalized and pass the bloody mic. Reform your own casteist, racist, transphobic and ableist households, dude. Don't teach us your methods of activism because they're exclusive as fuck. Instead, learn our methods which are more inclusive and follow our lead. Just remain silent and let the marginalized sections lead the movements. Basically, just shut up and let us speak. Most important thing, act on what you learn. Ironically, today me standing here and explaining you these things is where the problem lies. I mean, our leaders and women have been saying this forever. Read and learn about Savitri Bai Phule, Banwari Devi, Fatima Sheikh, Mukta Salve, Phulan Devi, Tarabai Shinde and many more amazing women. I'm not saying that you are bad if you are a Brahmin Dvija feminist. I'm just saying that you need to learn and unlearn many things. Till then, let's join hands and smash some Brahminical patriarchy.